Hello student, how are you? I hope you are fine and safe at your home. Today we are going to start chapter 4 from NCERT book, that's Tick Tick Tick. So let's begin. Our topic for today is Tick Tick Tick. It is related to time. If you observe the sound of watch, sound comes like tick tick tick. So what is a time? Time is ongoing sequence of event taking place. Basic unit of time is second. Different way to measuring time. First we measure time by watch, and for longer time we use day and month as well. Time is measured by using a clock. Clock is divided into 12 equal parts. Every clock has two thick needles. They are known as hand of clock. A clock is divided into 12 equal parts. The shorter hand of clock called hour clock, and longer hand of clock called minute hand. So if you look carefully, there are many small divisions between the number of a clock. There are 5 equal divisions between any two number. The total number of such equal division is clock is 60. Each division represent a minutes. One full circle of a clock have 60 minutes, that is 1 hour. So 1 hour is equal to 60 minutes, and 30 minutes is equal to half an hour. Now look at this clock. At hour hand is at 2 and minute hand is at 20 division from 12. So time is 2 hour 20 minute. We just learn there are 60 minute in 1 hour. So 1 hour is equal to 60 minute, and there are 30 minute in half an hour. Here are some units of time. 60 second is equal to 1 minute. 60 minute is equal to 1 hour. 24 hour is equal to 1 day. 30 days is equal to 1 month. 12 month is equal to 1 year. And 365 days is equal to 1 year. Reading time. Mostly we read time by clock, but longer time we measure it in days, month and week. So there are 12 months in a year. Here are the name of month and days of week. How to tell time in English? Minute hand goes in 5 minutes, so we call 5 past. Minute hand goes 2, we call 10 past. Minute hand goes from 3, we tell quarter past. In same way, if minute hand goes from 6, we call half past. So next topic for this chapter is half and quarter. So what is a half? When you strip something into two equal parts, each part is half of the whole. So this is the clock which I have drawn and divide into half from 12 to 6. This is known as half. And what is quarter? When you strip something in 4 equal parts, each part is quarter of whole. Now let's see some example. The hour hand is between 1 and 2, and the minute hand pointed to 3 means 15. So the time is 1:15. So we say is 1:15. It means 15 minutes after 1 o'clock. Here another clock. The hour hand between 2 and 3 and minute hand is that 6. So the time is 2:30. 2 hour 30 minute. 2 hour 30 minute. And we say is 2:30. Student, keep one thing in your mind whenever we say 1:30, 2:30, 3:30, we call as 1:30, 2:30, 3:30. It means the minute hand is half means around the clock. Now let's see another example. In this clock, hour hand between 1 and 2 and minute hand pointing to 9 means 45 minutes. So it is 1:45. 1 hour 45 minutes. So we say is 1:45. So student, that at 1:15, the minute hand always is point on 3, and 1:45, the minute hand always point 9. And one thing that 1/4 is the opposite of 1:15. So let's see. 60 minute is equal to 1 hour. 30 minute is equal to 1/2 hour. And 15 minute is equal to 1/4 hour. And one day is equal to 24 hours. So there are 24 hours in one day. Those 24 are divided into two parts. Each part is 12 hour clock. These parts are called AM and PM. The first part of the day goes to 12 midnight to 12 noon. And this is known as AM. It is morning, means from midnight 12 to 12 noon. We called AM. And from 12 noon to 12 midnight, we say PM. It is night. So student, AM and PM are the Latin. AM means after meridian or before noon. And PM is equal to past meridian or afternoon. I hope you understand the concept of AM and PM. So let's do some example. I wake up at 7. I eat lunch at 2:30 and I go to bed at 10. Here are some questions. So this is for your homework. You write down the correct answer, AM or PM. So there are 24 hours in one day. Those 24 hours divided into two parts. Each part is 12 hours. These parts are called AM and PM. The first part of the day goes to 12 midnight to 12 noon, and this is known as AM. It is morning, means from midnight 12 to 12 noon we call AM, and from 12 noon to 12 midnight we say PM. It is night. So student, AM and PM are Latin. AM means the antemeridian are before noon, and PM means post meridian. It means afternoon. in 12-hour clock, each time comes twice in a day. So let's do some another example. First question, how many hours it is from 3 p.m. to 6 p.m.? For solving this question, let us use timeline. Look at the timeline. 3 p.m. to 9 p.m. Here, 3 p.m. and 9 p.m. So let's count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. So how many hours between 3 p.m. to 9 p.m. is 6 hours. Next question, from 5 a.m. to 5 p.m. Simply, from 5 a.m. to 5 p.m. it is 12 hours. And now third question, 8 a.m. to 2 p.m. So we start from 8 p.m. from 2 p.m. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So time between 8 a.m. to 2 p.m. is 6 hours. Now 24-hour clock. From 24-hour clock, the day runs from midnight to midnight and it divided into 24 hours. Here the table mentioned 24-hour clock and 12-hour clock and 24-hour clock. 24-hour clock goes to midnight to midnight and 12-hour clock midnight to noon and noon to midnight. Here the table given for the 24-hour clock and 12-hour clock. For in 12-hour clock, 12 midnight we write a.m. and 24-hour clock we write 24:00. In same way, for 4 a.m. in 12-hour clock we write 4 hours in 24-hour clock. So now let's see book exercise. So this question in your book, in your maths book NCERT, page number 50. Question related to 12-hour clock and 24-hour clock. Here time given in 12-hour clock and you have changed to time in 24-hour clock. First, 1 o'clock in afternoon. So in 24-hour clock we write 13 hours. 12 o'clock in the afternoon, in 24-hour clock we write 14 hours. Next, 6 o'clock in the evening, in 24-hour clock we write 18 hours. 9 o'clock in the evening we write 21 hours in 24-hour clock. 12 o'clock in the evening we write 24 hours in 24-hour clock. Look at this chart and tell the difference between your watch and 24-hour clock. Now another exercise. This question is page number 51 in your NCERT maths book. The question is, suppose a train leaves at 8:30 at night, the time written on the railway ticket board 20:30. So 8:30 is written in 12-hour clock and railway ticket board use the 24-hour clock, so the time written in 20-30 hours. Next question is, write these using AMR PM. Time of sunrise and time of sunset. It is also discussed with you, so it do all self. Next topic is holiday for fun. This topic given in your NCERT book, page number 46. Here, a boy named Atif, his holidays are begun and he was very excited. He decided to write a letter to his cousin Shabana. He has written a letter from Ajmer 156. That is the date when he was written a letter. Then he has going to Nani's place to 556. Here are some dates. Atif going to Nani's place 556. Come to back 256. And Atif's school reopened 366. 555. First 5 is show dates. Second 5 show the month and third number show the year. So 556 is 5th May 2006. Now do some question it given in your NCERT book page number 47. Write these dates which stand for. First one is 556. It stand for 5th May 2006. 256. It stand for 20 May 2006. 766. It stand for 7 June 2006. 117. It stand for 1st of January 2007. Write these dates in number. 1st June 2006. We write in numerals 1, 1. Now do this question given in your NCERT book page number 47. First question is, write which date these stand for. First is 556. It stand for 5th May 2006. 256, 20 May 2006. 766, it stand for 7 June 2006. 117, it stand for 1st January 2007. Next question is, write this date in number. First one is 1st June 2006. It written is 166. Second question is 30 May 2006. It written is 356. Next question is 12 August 2007. It written is 12-8-7. Next question is, how long did it take Pilator to reach from Ajmer to Nagpur? Next question is, how long did it take the letter to reach from Ajmer to Nagpur? For solve this question, Atif wrote a letter on 1st May 2006. Her sister received letter on the 6th May 2006. So how long did it take time to reach Ajmer to Nagpur is 6 minus 1 is equal to 5. So later take 5 days to reach from Ajmer to Nagpur. Next question is, how many days will Atik spend at her nani's place? Atik went to nani's house 5, 5, 6, and when he came back on 25, 6, 25 minus 5 is equal to 15 days. So Atik spent 15 days at her nani's place. Next topic is manufacturing and expiry date. Manufacturing date means when that particular item has been made, and expiry date, it means when it is not useful. Here, look at the picture of tea packet. And here, the manufacturing date. For example, we take some particular item in their manufacturing date and expiry date. First, peanut 16 May 2020, and expiry date 15 November 2020. Between both the date, it is useful for us. Next item is tea. Here, the manufacturing date of tea is 16-6-20 and based before 12 month. It means it is useful for us 16-6-21. Between both the dates, it is useful for us. Next is cough syrup. Manufacturing date of cough syrup is 14 January 2020 and expiry date of this syrup is 13 January 2020. Between both the date, this cough syrup is useful for us. After 13 January 21, it is not useful for us. Students, we know that 1 year is equal to 12 months, 1 year is equal to 365 days, and 1 week is equal to 7 days. About them, we discussed before. Here, the name of 12 months and their number of days. You can see here the 4 month have 30 days, 7 month have 31 days, and February have 28 days, and leap year it is 29 days. So which month are 30 days? April, June, September and November. These 4 months have 30 days and other have 31 days. January, March, May, July, August, October and December. These 7 months have 31 days. Related to these, some question given in your NCERT maths book. First question is, between 10 June and 20 July, we find out the duration. So, first June have 30 days month. So, 30 minus 11 is equal to 19. And 19 plus 20. 20 is from 1 to 20 July. So 19 plus 20 is equal to 39 date. So time duration between 10th June to 20 July is 39 days. Next question is time duration between 26 December to 15 January. December is 31 days month. So 31 minus 27 is equal to 4. 4 plus 15. 15 January. So 4 plus 15 is equal to 19. So time duration between 26 December to 15 January is 19 days. Next question is time duration between 5th March to 10th May. March is 31 days month. So 31 minus 6 is equal to 25. 25 plus 30. 30 is the month of April. 30 is the month of April plus 10 May. So 25 plus 30 plus 10 is equal to 65. Next question is between 14 September to 22nd October. September is 30 days month. So 30 minus 15 is equal to 15. 15 plus 22. 22nd October. So 22. 15 plus 22 is equal to 37. So time duration between 14 September to 22nd October is 37 days. Next question is between 31st August and 10th September. August is 31st days month. So 31st minus 31st is equal to 0. 0 plus 10 is equal to 10. So time duration between 31st August to 10th September is equal to 10 days. Next question is complete the table given below. Here table is given starting date, duration and finishing date. First question is 24th January, duration 18 days. We find out the finishing date. Next question is 16th March, duration 13 days. We find out the finishing date. Next question, 14th May, duration is not given and finishing date is 23rd July. Next question, 23rd August, duration not given and 1st October. Let's see the solution. First question is 24th January. It is the starting date. Time duration is 18 days and finishing date is for find out. So January is the month of 31 days. So 31 minus 23, because 24 is the starting date. So before one day we count 23. So 31 minus 23 is equal to 8 and time duration is 18 days. So 18 minus 8 is equal to 10. So finishing date of that particular work is 10th February. In same way, you find out the answer for the second question. Now we solve the third question. Third question, 23rd August. It is the starting date. Duration is not given and finishing date is the 1st October. August is the month of 31 days. So 31 माइनस 22 इज इक्वल टू 9. 9 प्लस 9 plus 30 is equal to 39. So time duration between 31st starting date from 31st August and finishing date for 1st August is duration time is 39 days. In same way, you have to solve the question number 3. Here 14 Mai is given. It is the starting date. Your duration you have to find out and finishing date is given to 23rd July. Now, next question that given in your NCERT book is choose the correct answer. First question is 6:30 hours. Two options are given. First is the 6:30 a.m. and second one is the 6:30 p.m. So, 6:30 hours represent to 6:30 a.m. So right answer is 6:30 a.m. Next question is 11 hours. 11 here are given two options 11 a.m. and 11:30 p.m. So right answer is 11 a.m. Next question is 22:45 hours. For here are two options are given 10:45 a.m. and 10:45 p.m. So what will be the right answer for 22:45 hours? It is the 10:45 p.m. It is the right answer. Next question is 20 hours. Here are two options 8 a.m. and 8 p.m. So, what is the right answer for the 20 hours? 8 p.m. Next question is 14:20 hours. Here the two options 2:20 a.m. and 2:20 p.m. So right answer is 2:20 p.m. Next topic for this chapter is convert hour to minute. So first question is 8 hours. Solve. We know that 1 hour is equal to 60 minutes. So 8 hours is equal to 8 into 60 minutes. 60 into 8 is equal to 480. So right answer is 480 minutes. 8 hour for 480 minutes. Next question is 3 hours 20 minutes. For 1 hour is equal to 60 minutes. 3 hours is equal to 3 into 60 minutes. Is equal to 180 minutes. And for 20 minutes we add. So 180 minutes plus 20 minutes is equal to 200 minutes. So 3 hours 20 minutes is equal to 200 minutes. Question number 3 is 9 hours and question number 4 is 4 hours and 10 minutes. It is for your homework. You do yourself at your notebook. So students, today's our topic tick 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 is complete. I hope you understand in my class. I hope you understand all the topics in my class. So have a good day and we meet in next video. So see you and thank you.